Srimad Bhagavatam is compared to the ripened fruit of Vedic wisdom. The third verse of Srimad Bhagavatam says, Nigama kalpataror galitam phalam sukamukhadamrutadrava samyutam pibata bhagavatam rasamalayam muhurahorasika bhuvibhavukaham Nigama kalpataror galitam phalam. When all the Vedic literatures are compared to a desire-fulfilling tree, Srimad Bhagavatam is compared to the ripened fruit of the desire tree of Vedic literatures. Nigama means Vedic literatures, Kalpataru means desire tree, Nigama Kalpataror Galitam Phalam. The ripened fruit of this desire tree of Vedic literatures is Srimad Bhagavatam. And when the fruit is bitten by the beak of a parrot, its flavor increases. Similarly, Sukha Mukhad Amrutadrava Samyutam. Because this Srimad Bhagavatam was spoken by Srila Sukadeva Goswami, Pibata Bhagavatam Rasamalayam. So one has to drink this nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam that describes all kinds of transcendental mellows. Pibata Bhagavatam means Bhagavatam is compared to a fruit. You don't drink a fruit. You generally eat a fruit. But here, Bhagavatam is compared to a fruit, and in the third line of this shloka, it is said that we have to drink that fruit. Means, Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur beautifully says that in this ripened fruit of Vedic literatures, Srimad Bhagavatam, there are no objectionable parts of the peel, or inside there is no seed also. It is directly semi-solid juice that can be just drunk. So Bhagavatam is the natural commentary of Vedanta Sutras. So one can just drink the message of Bhagavatam without having to exert oneself. Pibata Bhagavatam Rasamalayam Muhur. And how long we should drink? Muhur means constantly. One has to constantly drink the nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam. So Rasam Alayam means it is described that this alaya is the highest stage of devotional service where one even faints in the ecstasy of love of Godhead. By studying Srimad Bhagavatam, Acharya say that one can attain ecstasy, one can faint, and one should get up again and again drink. Muhur, aho, rasika, bhuvi bhavukaha. So rasika means relishers of mellows, bhuvi bhavukaha means very thoughtful people on this planet. They actually can relish Srimad Bhagavatam by drinking this nectar. So it's a very high stage, certainly, but taking inspiration from these verses of Srimad Bhagavatam, we can take our baby steps to cultivate some little taste for the study of Srimad Bhagavatam and then continue with the mercy of Srila Prabhupada and the Acharyas. Thank you.